Welcome to Customizing Your Focus Blue Braille Display. I'm Ron Miller with the Vispero Training Department, and I'm going to show you six ways you can customize your Focus Blue Braille Display. We're going to talk about turning status cells on and off, showing the system time in the status cells, turning Braille highlighting on and off, enabling and disabling flash messages, setting the duration and verbosity of flash messages, and finally, setting the clock and calendar on the Focus Blue Braille Display. On my computer right now, JAWS is set to display status cells at the left end of my Braille display. I'm going to show you how to turn that off. The first thing we need to do is to go into JAWS Settings Center. You're going to press Insert and Number Row 6.
Windows OS JAWS Settings Center dialog.
The first thing we want to do is set the Settings Center so that all of your changes are applied globally. We're going to press Control-Shift-D, and I'll do the command from the Braille display.
JAWS Settings Center default all applications.
Now, let's enter the word status in the search edit field.
JAWS Settings Center default all applications dialog. Placement of status cells, one of four search results.
So placement of status cells is the option that we want, but I have to press down arrow to actually get to it, to put focus on that choice. We'll press down arrow. We'll use one of the rocker bars on the front panel of the Braille display.
Four search results list box. Placement of status cells left. Advanced.
And we'll press enter.
Search edit box cleared. Tree view. Placement of status cells left. 1 of 3. Advanced Braille.
So focus has now moved to that setting, and you can cycle through your choices by pressing the space bar. Right now, as you heard and can see, status cells are set at the left end of my Braille display. I can press space.
Space, right, 2 of 3.
Which moves them to the right end of my Braille display. Now you won't have seen a change yet because I have not applied this setting. But we are now selected to show the status cells at the right of the Braille display. And if you don't want status cells at all, press space one more time.
Space, none, 3 of 3.
Let's tab to the OK button and press space.
Read only edit, use these, apply button, OK button, space. Sharing control bar Microsoft Teams web content profile 2 page.
Go back
desktop,
to my desktop.
Folder view list view, VPN my documents.
And as you can see, the status cells no longer appear at the left end or the right end of my Braille display. I have turned them off. In order to turn the clock view on in your status cells, you'll need to first go to JAWS Settings Center. You're going to do that by pressing Insert and Number 6.
Windows OS JAWS Settings Center dialog.
Now let's enter clock into the search edit field.
Display clock slash time and status cells, 1 of 1 search results.
But first we have to press down arrow. I'll press the rocker bar down on the front panel of our Braille display.
Clock, 1 search results list box. Display clock slash.
And I'll stop speech. I'll press enter to move focus to this option in the tree view.
Search edit box cleared. Tree view. Display clock slash time and status cells, closed. 7 of 7.
Let's open this branch of the tree view by pressing right arrow.
Display clock slash time and status cells, open, 3 items.
We'll press down arrow.
Level 2, show time and status cells not checked, 1 of 3. Display clock slash time and status cells Braille.
So the first thing I have is a checkbox, which allows me to decide whether I wish to show the time in the status cells. I'll press the space bar to check this box.
Space, checked.
There's a check now there.
24 hours format not checked.
I can decide whether I want 12 or 24-hour format. I like 24-hour format. Of course, you can make a different choice. I'm going to check this box by pressing space.
Space, checked.
Once we've set up our display the way we want it, we have the clock settings set the way we want to have them displayed, we can tab to the OK button and press space.
Read only edit. Choose the apply button. OK button. Space. Sharing control bar Microsoft Teams web content profile 2 page. Desktop. Folder view list view. JAWS 2000.
And at the left end of the display, currently you see I have it set to hours and minutes view. I'm using 24-hour time, and right now it's 1505 hours. Highlighting is the use of dots 7 and 8 in the Braille cell to indicate that the text on screen is highlighted. If we look at the virtual Braille viewer at the top of the screen and you look at the dot patterns display, you'll notice that under JAWS, space, and then there's a number sign, 2025. Under each one of those characters is dots 7 and 8 that indicates that this item is actually selected on the desktop. It changes the way these characters look. So some people may wish to turn highlighting off, and I'm going to show you how to do that. And the first thing I want to do is configure Settings Center to the default setting so that all the changes we make are applied globally. You're going to press Control-Shift-D, Delta. to make that change.
Just settings center default all applications.
Now I'm going to enter the word highlight into the search edit field.
Indicate smart glance highlights, 1 of 11 search results.
I'll just press down. I'm using the left rocker bar. It's easy to hit using my thumb.
Highlight checked. Braille marking, braille marking, braille.
And that's the one we want. Highlight under braille marking. Let's press enter to move focus into that option on the tree view.
Search edit box cleared. Tree view. Highlight checked. 1 of 8. Braille marking, braille marking, braille.
I can press space to uncheck this checkbox.
Space. Not checked.
Now we're going to press tab until we reach the OK button and press space.
Read only edit. Select apply button. OK button. Space.
Now we're back on the desktop with JAWS showing. JAWS 2025. And you'll notice dots 7 and 8 are absent. If you look at your Braille viewer, you can see that dots 7 and 8 are no longer appearing below JAWS number sign 2025. Flash messages are the brief Braille messages that JAWS sends to your refreshable Braille display that provide the same information that might be spoken when JAWS makes an announcement. Some people like these flash messages. Everybody uses them with very few exceptions. But what if I wish to turn them off? How do I do that? I'm going to show you. The first thing we're going to do is go into JAWS Settings Center by pressing Insert Numero 6. And that's the 6 above the QWERTY keys. And I'll issue that command right from the Braille keyboard here. So Insert Numero 6.
Windows OS JAWS Settings Center dialog.
Now, I'll enter the word flash into the search edit field.
JAWS Settings Center default all applications dialog. Ignore flash on web pages. 1 of 4 search results.
So we've got 4 different search results. I'm going to use the left rocker bar. You can use either one. But I'm going to arrow down through our results till I find the one that I want.
Flash. 4 search results list box. Ignore flash messages. Braille.
We want to go to the flash messages section in the Braille part of the tree view. I'm going to press enter to move focus to those options.
Search edit box cleared. Tree view. Flash messages closed. 4 of 7. Braille.
Now the flash messages branch is closed. I'll press right arrow to open it.
Flash messages. Open. 5 items.
And I'll press down arrow again using the rocker bar on the front panel of the Braille display.
Level 2. Enable flash messages checked. 1 of 5. Flash messages Braille.
So this is pretty straightforward. You've got a checkbox which you can check or uncheck to enable or disable flash messages. I have my flash messages enabled, so the checkbox is checked. All I do is press space.
Space, not checked.
To disable flash messages and JAWS announcements, any other informational things that JAWS would tell me will no longer be sent to the Braille display. You might find that you want to do that if the flash messages are distracting or for some other reason. So now that this is unchecked, I can tab to the OK button and press space.
Read only edit. Select this check apply button. OK button. Space. Sharing control bar.
I'm going to show you how to change verbosity for your flash messages and also duration of the message, which means how long it's displayed or shown on your Braille display. The first thing I'm going to do is go into Settings Center by pressing Insert Numero 6, which is the number 6 above the QWERTY keys, and I'm going to issue that Insert Numero 6 command right from the Braille keyboard.
Windows OS JAWS.
Now I'll enter flash into the search edit field.
JAWS Settings Center default all applications dialog. Ignore flash on web pages. 1 of 4 search results.
We have 4 search results. I'm going to use the left or right rocker bar. In my case, I'll use the left one. The rocker bars are on the front panel of your Focus Braille display. I'm going to use one of these rocker bars to actually arrow down to the option that I need.
Flash. 4 search results list box. Ignore flash on web pages, not flash messages, Braille.
And there's flash messages, Braille. That tells us the option and what part of the tree view it's in. Let's press enter to actually move focus to that part of the tree view.
Search edit box cleared. Tree view. Flash messages closed. 4 of 7, Braille.
Now this branch of the Braille tree is closed. Let's press right arrow to open it.
Flash messages open. 5 items.
And let me press down arrow once by pressing the rocker bar down.
Level 2. Enable flash messages not checked. 1 of 5. Flash messages Braille.
In the first video about flash messages, I did uncheck this box by pressing space, so flash messages are currently disabled. Let's press spacebar to re-enable flash messages.
Space. Checked.
Okay, let's arrow down.
Flash message timeout. 2,000 milliseconds.
Flash message timeout. This setting delineates how long the flash message appears on your Braille display. I've got mine set for 2,000 milliseconds, which is the same as 2 seconds. You can change this value in one of two ways. You can either press the space bar.
Space, 3,000 milliseconds, space, 4,000 milliseconds, 4 of 15.
Or, so let's go ahead and press up arrow, or by pressing up on the left or right rocker bar, to return to 2,000 milliseconds, which is my preferred setting.
3,000 milliseconds, 2,000 milliseconds, 2 of 15.
And you can use this to set any value you want. Let me show you the last value in our selection. I'm going to press end.
End, manually clear only, 15 of 15.
Manually clear only is a setting I want you to know about. If you've got a Braille reader who takes a little longer, the flash messages will appear and the reader will have to press a cursor router button, one of these buttons here above the Braille cells, to actually clear that message. So with this setting, manually clear only, a reader can take as much time as needed to read the message, and then once they're ready, they can press a cursor router button to actually clear the message. I really would like to set mine back for 2 seconds. Let's press the home command.
Home, 1,000 milliseconds, 1 of 15.
I'll arrow down once.
2,000 milliseconds, 2 of 15.
Let's press F6 to get back to the tree view.
Tree view, flash message timeout, 2,000 milliseconds.
And we'll tab to OK and press space.
Read only edit, apply button, OK button, space. Sharing control bar Microsoft.
Setting the clock on the Focus Blue Braille display involves using the clock settings option in the configuration menu. To open the configuration menu from the status line, which is what is displayed when there are no active connections on your Focus Blue Braille display, you press the menu button. The menu button is the button which appears between dots 1 and 4 on the Braille keyboard. Once the menu button is pressed, the configuration menu will open and you'll see Focus either 14, 40, or 80, depending on the Focus Braille display version you're using, and the Bluetooth MAC address. You'll navigate through the various options in the configuration menu by pressing the rocker bar up or down. These are the rocker bars located on the front of the Braille display. I'm going to press down on the rocker bar to reach the clock setting. You can press either up or down. You will reach all settings. This menu wraps. I'm going to use down because it requires a few less presses of the rocker bar. And I've reached clock. The Braille display simply shows the word clock. Now we'll press the right shift button. This opens up that setting. The clock display is shown, and you'll see hours, minutes, and seconds. Dots 7 and 8 are used to highlight the segment which will be adjusted. You'll adjust the value of the highlighted segment by pressing up or down on one of the rocker bars. So, for example, my clock is currently set to 24-hour time. You may have yours set to 12-hour time. It doesn't matter in this instance. But mine is showing 15 hours, which would be 3 p.m. If I wished to decrement or reduce the value of the hours, I would press down on the rocker bar. And the value changes. I'm now at 10 hours. Let's go back up to 15. To change the minutes value, you would press the right panning button, which is the rightmost control on your 40 or 80 Focus Blue Braille display, and it is right next to the right shift button if you're using a Focus 14 Blue. You can also tell it's the right panning button because it does have the double right arrow symbol on it. Let's press that once. Now the minute value has dot 7 and 8 below it, and again, you can increase or decrease the value of that by pressing up or down on the rocker bars. If you press the panning button to the right again, or the right panning button again, the seconds value become highlighted with dots 7 and 8, and again, you can use the up or down press on the rocker bar to change that value. Finally, if you press right arrow again, the highlight moves, dots 7 and 8, to the 24 or 12 hour selection. And again, you can change that by pressing up or down on one of the rocker bars. When you're done setting your clock and choosing the 12 or 24 hour value time, you would press the right selector button, which is the right button with a concave top. Press the right selector button. That will cause the Focus Braille display to accept your changes and to move back to the configuration menu. Pressing the right selector button again exits the configuration menu and saves your settings. Setting the calendar on your Focus Blue Braille display involves using the configuration menu. You can open the configuration menu by pressing the menu button, which appears between dots 1 and 4 on the Braille display. When the configuration menu is open, you'll see the words focus and a number value. So focus 14, 40, or 80, depending on the Braille display version you're using at this moment, and the Bluetooth MAC address of the Braille display. You'll reach the calendar option by pressing up or down on the rocker bars, which appear on the front panel of the Braille display. I'll use the left rocker bar, but you can use either one. I'll press down on the rocker bar to reach the calendar. You can press either up or down. You can navigate through this menu in either direction. The menu does wrap. Once you've reached the calendar option, press the right shift button to open that option. The elements of the calendar are displayed on your Braille display. You've got year, month, and day, and then you've got a way to select the format in which the calendar appears. We'll talk about that in a moment. The element that's being adjusted is highlighted using dots 7 and 8. So, for example, on my display on screen now, the year 2025 is highlighted with dots 7 and 8. I can increase or decrease it by pressing up or down on the rocker bar. So if I press down on the rocker bar, the value changes. It now shows 2019. Let's press up again to return it to 2025. Let's press the right panning button, which is the button that has the right double arrow symbol. And the highlighting moves to the month element. So you'll see dots 7 and 8 under the month. In this case, I'm showing 01 as the month because I'm recording this in January. If I wish to change that value, if I press the rocker bar up, it will say 02, 03, 04, and so on. If I press the rocker bar down, since I'm in January, the value will change to 12, of course, for December. This also is an item that wraps. I'm going to switch it back to January by pressing up on the rocker bar. If I press the right panning button again, highlighting is moved to the day value. And again, I can change that. I can increment it or decrement it by pressing up or down on the rocker bar. If I press the right panning button again, I now move to the calendar format option. Currently, it is set to show year, month, and date. So what I'm seeing on the Braille display is YYYY/MM/DD. I can change that by pressing up or down on the rocker bar. So if I want year, month, day, I can leave it there. I can press the rocker bar. I'll press up in this instance. And it changes to day, month, year, or DDMM, YYYY. If I press up again, it changes to month, day, year, and then back to year, month, day. I'm going to set mine to day, month, year, because that's what we use for the most part here in the US. To accept my changes and to leave this option, I press the right selector button. That's the button on the right side of the Braille display with a concave top. And if I press that button again, I will leave the configuration menu and return to the status line. Thank you for celebrating Braille Literacy Month with us. I hope these tips are helpful for you as you use your Focus Blue Braille display.
Freedom Scientific, a Vispero brand. Thanks for tuning in. Be sure to check out more content like this at freedomscientific.com/training.